there is a pattern. They are targeting minorities, actually non-locals and minorities, and they want local communal harmony to be disturbed.
ये जो हत्याओं का सिलसिला चल रहा है, इससे साफ जाहिर होता है कि किसी पर्टिकुलर कम्युनिटी और हिंदू कम्युनिटी को टारगेट किया जा रहा है। ये अपने आप में वही डिज़ाइन अपनाने की कोशिश की जा रही है कि कश्मीर से हिंदुओं को वहाँ से निकाला जाए।
जिन लोगों ने घटना की है, मैं समझता हूँ कि जल्द ही वो हम आप सबके सामने होंगे और परिणाम आप देखें। यहाँ जो आपस में प्रेम और मोहब्बत है, ये चिन्हित करके ऐसे निर्दोष लोगों को मारना ताकि इस तरह की भावना यहाँ पैदा हो।
Namaste and welcome to this edition of The Right Stand. It's a straightforward question. Is this Hindu messiah which is on display in Jammu and Kashmir hatred for non-Muslims? And is this the Islamist bent that needs to be challenged? A deliberate attempt to once again try and stoke fear and uncertainty at a time when Jammu and Kashmir is taking great strides towards peace and progress. Let's understand this, why we are saying it's a deeper hate, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm going to go straight into the heart of the matter. The perpetrators are Lashkar and the Lashkar remnants in Jammu and Kashmir. Those who are trying to do, who have now become frustrated and desperate to try and make an impact. Overground workers are now turning into terrorists. And that's why this change in pattern of violence. The message is what? Non-Muslims and minorities stay out of Jammu and Kashmir. So when is this? And then targets civilians, social workers and philanthropists. These are people who have come up in life the hard way, who are contributing to society and who are standing steadfast with the tricolor. And that's why they want to cancel them out and try and stoke this unrest and fear. There is a new Jammu and Kashmir Domicile Act which has come through. That is why they are shaken. There are the government of India's efforts to not only resettle Kashmiri Pandits and Hindus, but also to get back, give them back or hand them back what has been, what was taken away from them forcefully more than three decades ago during the Kashmir Hindu exodus. So these are the aspects which are irritating them, along with the Jammu and Kashmir delimitation exercise and the entire electoral process that is going to redefine the politics. All of this is the reason why we are seeing this kind of a desperate act. But amidst their effort to try and stoke a certain amount of uncertainty and panic among the minorities, the Jammu and Kashmir police, the IG, Vijay Kumar, has now released a statement, and I'm going to go straight across to that. This is important, ladies and gentlemen. And he says, the Jammu and Kashmir police has reassured the public, saying, believe in us. We will account for these cowards. We will bring them to justice. But more importantly, the numbers say that the reason to worry is not much. They are just trying to saber rattle. We should stand up to this kind of threatening, this kind of cowardice, and we should give back in equal measure. They are saying total 28 civilians have been killed by terrorists this year in 2021. Of the 28, five people belong to local Hindu and Sikh community, two non-local Hindu laborers. Out of 28, it is five people, is what the Jammu and Kashmir police is saying. Due to the killing of huge numbers of terrorists of all outfits, especially their leadership, destruction of their support structure, and continuous and effective maintenance of law and order, terrorist handlers across, that means direct indication of this is Pak sponsored and Pak orchestrated, have got frustrated and changed their strategy and started targeting unarmed policemen, innocent civilians, politicians, and now innocent civilians from the minority communities, including women. In all such cases, terrorists have been using pistols. These acts are committed by newly recruited terrorists or those who are about to join the terrorist rank. In some cases, OGWs or overground workers have been found directly involved. Jammu and Kashmir police is working hard and we are identifying all such part-time hybrid terrorists and strictest action shall be taken against them. We receive several leads and are working on it. We have also been launching operations along with other security forces. We appeal to the general public, especially minority communities, not to panic. We have been maintaining peace and secured the environment and will continue to do so. So this is the assurance and promise coming in from the Jammu and Kashmir police, saying those who are trying to stoke fear, those who are trying to ensure that the syncretic ethos of Jammu and Kashmir is not returned, Kashmiris are not given their rights, then we are not going to allow that. We are going to thwart that. Just give us some time. Believe in us. In fact, I've just got another information, piece of information, that the average longevity of those who have tried to take up terrorism in Jammu and Kashmir in the recent past is just about 1 week. It's just about 1 week. So it's like they are like fireflies. They will burn and then they will also perish very soon. That's the word coming through, that these are fireflies. They will not be, their longevity is limited, their lifespan is limited, and this message is loud and clear. This message is the most important message right now. We'll keep this reassurance, we'll keep this promise of the Jammu and Kashmir police and the security forces on ground, saying we are mounting a coordinated effort, or you will get the message very, very soon that these people, these cowards have been accounted for. They've been extracted and they will be exterminated. That is the assurance that's coming through. Amit Raina is with us. Lalit Ambardar is with us. Sardar R.P. Singh with us. The assurance is very, very timely. But the fact is that along with negating these pests or controlling them, the thought process has to be also eliminated. Lalit Ambardar, for long you have been saying, this is jihad at play. These are elements who have got a rabid hatred and non-acceptance for anybody who's non-Muslim in Jammu and Kashmir. And that thought process has to be culled.
Anand, you're exactly what it is. This is how it has to be called. Kashmir Jihad is all about supremacy and incompatibility of Islam with the rest. This is what Jihad is all about in the rest of the world. Afghanistan, your neighborhood, what they have done there. Right? And Kashmir, it began, Kashmir Jihad began with this kind of intent. Yahan kya chalega Nizam-e-Mustafa when they executed genocide of Kashmiri Hindus, when rape, murder or mass murder were used as tools of genocide. And within few months, you almost cleansed Kashmir Valley of 5,000 years of civilizational background. And the target was Kashmir mein rehna hoga, Allahu Akbar kehna hoga. These flowery words coming from different political parties, I don't know. I don't even want to even address them. They need to take the cognizance of the fact what Kashmir, what India has on hand in Kashmir is purely Kashmir Jihad. It's not a political problem. It's not a law and order problem. And Kashmiri Hindus have been the worst victims of it, and they are being still used. I'm so sorry to say, and I must say this. Kashmiri Hindus are being used, continue to be used as guinea pigs in India's continued secular experimentations in Kashmir. My boys and girls who belong to the depraved section of my society, they need jobs. They belong to the survivors of genocide. And it's the responsibility of the government of India to provide them jobs. And where do it? They exploit their deprivation, push them into, say, very villages and towns of Kashmir, from where their parents, their families were kicked out 32 years ago. And today they are sitting ducks. You have to go and visit the camps. What is their condition today? That is the thing. And we have not even yet formally acknowledged by this state even, by this government also even, that what Kashmiri Hindus suffered was genocide. Not one case of murder, mass murder has been ever pursued.
I agree with you, Lalit.
Are moving free in Kashmir.
Lalit ji, I agree with you. But there is also...
I want to appeal through you. No, listen, 10 seconds more. Jee. Through you, I want to appeal to the government of India. Please rescue my Hindus and my Hindu boys and girls in Kashmir. Shift them to Jammu. Let them be there till
no.
you.
No, this is where
Kashmir
I disagree with you, sir. This is where I disagree with you, sir. Where I say that the acknowledgement has to happen, but there has to be no submission. There is no leaving our land at the hand of these people.
No, I'm not talking about submission.
No, sir,
but at the same time, you cannot use
the
Hindus
fact
for,
is, no, nobody, no, sir, the fact yes, is one, that, fact is, sir, fact is, fact is, Lalit ji, fact is, Lalit ji, fact is, Lalit ji, that we have to stand up and we have to collectively go there and tell them that you don't have the gumption, neither you will run out of bullets, but we will not run out of resolve. And the fact is that this is the, these times have changed. Gone are the times, sir. Gone are the times when their brandishing the gun was not countered. Now when they lift the gun, they know that their countdown has already begun. The average is less than 1 week. And the security forces have committed that it will be, that average will be brought down to a matter of days, to a level that they will now be worried. They will be the one who should be afraid to even pick up the gun. That's the turnaround that is required, and that will be done only with resolve. Sir, the IG statement is very, very clear. Out of 28 civilians who have been killed this year, the total number of non-Muslims or Hindus and Sikh is 5. The latest act of cowardice, the latest act of cowardice has come as a sign of desperation to try and instill a certain level of fear. Listen. But these are cowards, sir. When they target a woman, when they target a doctor, when they target a Golgappa wala, that means ye dar gaye, sir. That's the change. But in terms of, no, but Lalit ji,
them as well kafir.
Lalit ji, I agree with you that the government has to do justice. The government has to accept that what happened in the 80s and the 90s was nothing short of genocide. There has to be cognizance, and they have to do justice by all those people who for the last three and a half decades have left their homeland and they've not got justice. But Sardar RP Singh, the other aspect is that this is the time that you don't back down, you stare them back in the face and you push them out. You send them back to those holes that they have come out of, crept out of, and then you bury them for good in those holes. The fact is that this is the lot that needs a reminder of 2 centuries ago of Hari Singh Nalwa.
Anand, you took a name of a person who used to make them scared like anything. I mean, he made them wear salwar kameez instead of the tamba they used to wear. I mean, that Prime Minister of the Pakistan who wears salwar kameez, his forefather started wearing salwar kameez because of Hari Singh Nalwa. But coming to the present situation, my humble request, and then to my co-panelists from Kashmir, the Kashmiri Pandit, that don't compare the situation in the 90s. 90s was a different situation. Today is different. Today, government is hands down with the situation, and they'll be disassured. All those who have done what they have done in the last 4 or 5 days will be properly rewarded. Rewarded means they'll be properly taken care, and then they'll be properly taken to task. And also, that need be, the Indian government can go across the border also to give the strong message, to give the message to their bosses also. So let's be clear. There's a track record of this government. So they'll be taken care. Don't bother about that. And then we will not allow 90s to happen again, because there's a certain set of media who's trying to present as if 90s have come back. I'm sorry. That narrative would not work. This is Prime Minister Modi's government. And then with Amit Shah ji as a home minister, be very rest assured. Within the next 2-3 days, you will see what's happening on the ground. And what Anand said, that the 7 days will come down to 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and then there'll be no terrorists left in Kashmir in coming days. Be rest assured on this.
I salute the spirit, Sardar RP Singh, but for that one aspect is, sir, there has to be a clear difference. Of what Jammu and Kashmir requires in terms of cleansing this kind of an Islamist bent and radicalist mindset which is being fueled from the other side. And separate that from the entire peace, progress and development story. These are two different aspects. One cannot be clouded over with the other. That is something which we have to be very, very clear of. There is no looking the other way.
I accept that and we don't want to mix up two. Where are our Hurriyat leaders today? Where are all those leaders who used to talk about Nizam-e-Mustafa? They're all behind bars, and cases are on them. And none of them will be spared. People who killed the Air Force commandos, they'll be taken care. They'll be properly prosecuted as per law now. They had a lot of time out, being out. So none of them will be spared. and then be rest assured, overgrown worker or the real terrorist, both will be taken care. Both will be sent behind bar or will be killed. Be rest assured on this. There's no other way out of this. I'm using harsh word, but only request to my Kashmiri Pandit friends and brothers, I put on and don't run away from the situation. It's not 90s. There's no announcement from any masjid now. There'll be no demonstrations in favor of these terrorists now on road. We like Sikhs in valley. We Sikhs are fighting it back. We are not going to run off the Kashmir. We are our brothers in Kashmir. We'll fight it back together. Be rest assured, all Kashmiri Pandits will have get full respect and get place which is required in the valley. And then today, ecosystem is also changing. Today, it's not that people go along with the terrorists. When terrorists die, people gather together and then go along with the terrorists. There are people who are coming on board against terrorists today.
Yeah, there are more people raising voice and in solidarity against these killings. I agree with that, but there is a little more that needs to be done. Amit Raina, while questions should be raised about whether the government is doing its doing enough, there should also be a certain amount that the entire Kashmiri Hindu fraternity has to turn around and stand up. They have to take the attitude displayed by Simriti Bindru, not turn around and try and suddenly fearmonger and say, oh, let's get away, let's go away, let's shift out of Jammu, let's shift out of Kashmir, there's no point going back. This attitude is what helps them fuel the fire. Then they know that the next time there is an effort which is made, just go ahead and shoot one or two more people, again they will all run away. This is not a nation of Birus. That is another aspect which is very important, and you have to turn around and consider this. You can't sit there, you have to go and fight with them. You have to stare them back in the face and say, get out.
Anand, let me assure you through your channel, to every Indian, to every Kashmiri, to every Kashmiri terrorist in Pakistan, that Kashmiri Pandits are never going to give up their claim on Kashmir. And we are an integral part of that place, and we are going to claim it back. Now, coming back to killing of terrorists. There's one thing which is about killing terrorists, and another thing is killing of terrorism. They are two separate things. You can keep on killing terrorists, but until you don't kill terrorism, the things will keep on cropping up. In an effort, after 2019, in an effort to win hearts and minds of Kashmir, the government of Jammu and Kashmir and the government of India went a step further, and they went beyond winning hearts and minds. They went to the step of appeasement. Do you know, in last 1 year, there has not been a single caso in Srinagar city? Not a single caso in Srinagar city, in spite of Srinagar city having higher number of killings than the trouble-torn areas of Pulwama, Kulgam and Shopian. You still had no caso happening in Srinagar city. Why? Because you didn't want to, you wanted to appease people, you wanted them to feel nice. And this is what has ended up today, that a terrorist gets up today, chooses his victim, chooses his place, chooses his timing and kills him. Can you believe in a school they pull out teachers, identify them by their I-cards, then pull out two who are non-Muslims and kill them? It happens in the heart of the Srinagar. Why? Because there has been an appeasement policy. Now, if you want Kashmiri Pandits to be back, it is not only about Kashmiri Pandits going back. Every Indian has a claim on Kashmir. Yeah. Every soldier who has martyred himself in Kashmir, his family has a claim on Kashmir. Kashmir is as much as mine as of every soldier who has served in Kashmir. But for that, you will have to have a strategy in place. You will have to create a separate area where the people who believe in Constitution of India, who believe in a cultural ethos, who believe in living together, come together, and you create that area for them, and that population expand. If you today you allow Kashmiri Pandits to sit like to be ready to be shot like pigeons, then I don't think there's no point losing a life. लड़ाई जीत मरने से नहीं जीती जाती है, लड़ाई मारने से जीती जाती है. और उस मारने के लिए हमें हथियार भी चाहिए और हमें संख्या भी चाहिए. एंड यू विल हैव टू प्रोवाइड अस दैट. अनलेस यू डोंट प्रोवाइड अस दैट, यू एक्सपेक्ट मी टू
फाइट 50,000 पीपल विद AK-47 सिटिंग एंड सेइंग let them come back in those big numbers. I'm saying
we are willing to come back. Give us a separate area.
It's about coming back. It's just about coming back and taking what was taken away from them. And it has to be done. There is a certain pressure that has to be built. I am just saying three jokers in a remote school in Srinagar are claimed to be able to build a pressure on 4 lakh families. Is that what you are trying to know, sir? So 4 lakh families has to go back and ensure that these 200-300 jokers never turn up again. These three jokers never turn up again. I am just saying, there has to be. You cannot make me a sitting duck. Nobody is a sitting duck today, sir. Like I said, sir, the number that has been put out right now, out of 28 civilians who've been killed in all of 2021, five of them are non-Muslims. And these five also is happening, Amit Raina, you know very well. These
five... 4,000.
These five people are also being singled out right now because there is a certain amount of movement which is happening as far as the electoral process, the Domicile Act, and also the return of property of the Kashmiri migrants.
Anand, Kashmiri Pandits are only 4,000. You are 4,000. We are only 4,000.
Sir, there were 4 lakh families, right? There were 4 lakh families, right? I am tonight saying. For Supinder Kaur and Dipak Chahar, I am saying every single family that left should now turn back and land up in Srinagar and say give me back my place right now. I want it right now. Let them turn around and build their pressure. Arriving in Srinagar, sir, not sitting elsewhere across the world and the country. That is the kind of spirit that needs to be displayed. What Dipak Chahar's brother showed today, where he told the terrorist that you have my brother's phone, you killed my brother, you have his phone and you're trying to scare me. I am telling you on national media that I am not going to be scared. I will come and take up his place and I will do his job. I will take up that job. I'm not going to be scared.
Anand, I bought a house last month. I bought a house, sir, justice has to be delivered, but the pressure has to be built on these Islamist radicals
by in the right manner, sir. This is the right time to build that pressure, and Sardar RP Singh, that needs to be done, not in bits and pieces and bobs. Not sending 2-3 people. Lalit Ambardar's position was very clear. You have pulled out somebody who fled that village and you have put that person back in that village and left them open, as open targets.
Anand, it's just a matter of time. I'm telling you, just wait for another 6 months to 1 year. All these Kashmiri Pandits will flock to Srinagar and wherever they have come from. Have my word.
33 years, they're still waiting. I can't help what happened earlier. Yes, Lalit Ambardar.
I worked in Kashmir for 10 years, sir. I've been to each and every village.
Sir, what Narendra Modi did on 5th of August 2019, that's only one aspect of crushing that Islamo-fascistic ecosystem that has been flourishing in Kashmir because of 370 and 35A. Aapka wahan pe Pakistan phal phool raha tha. Lekin remember, we were 4.5 lakh in 90, scattered all over the length and breadth of Kashmir. And you could, Indian state could not protect us that time because we were vulnerable, we were abandoned. All these years we were abandoned. Now you expect the survivors of genocide go and face, come back and as non-combatants.
No, but now you are not abandoned. Now you are not abandoned. Now is the time to turn around and amp up the pressure by landing up and claiming what is yours.
Land up, turn up, and claim what is yours.
And you have to show the spine to fight back now because there are those who are standing with you to fight back, Lalit Ambardar. So I am also saying, sir, hate is also fueled and hate is encouraged when you succumb and fall to that hate. Nobody is committing suicide, sir. If you want to fight the bully, you have to stand up to the bully also. With due respect, you have to stand up to the bully.
I am going to kill. If you are allowing me to kill, I am going to kill.
No, stand up to the bully. I am just saying, stand up to the bully. The strength is in numbers. The more the numbers are, are going to put pressure both ways. You are going to put pressure both ways. That is what I am trying to say. And Sardar R.P. Singh, the point is, sir.
You cannot do that, sir. Today, this is not a.
You can, sir. You can, sir. You can, sir. You can put enough pressure if you have the belief, and if you are united, you can put enough and more pressure to ensure that not a single bullet is fired at an innocent Jammu and Kashmir citizen by a terrorist sponsored by Pakistan.
Listen,
you can do it, sir, if you show the will. Stand with the forces. Stand with the forces. Put the pressure on the system to back you up, to enable you in the way you should be. But you should also stand up and do your bit. Taali ek haath se nahi bajti, dono haath se bajti hai, is what I can tell you. That's all I have time for. Amit Raina. Amit Raina, Sardar R.P. Singh. No, sir. Sir, you got to do it in Jammu and Kashmir. And the doors are open. Nobody is stopping any Kashmiri Hindu, any Kashmiri from entering Kashmir today. That's the reality. That's all we have time for in this edition of The Right Stand. Stay with us.